was not applying to enough grad programs. And I say that feeling like I ended up in the best place for me. But I think if you have the privilege of time and money to send in more applications and do more interview weekends, I think they're good experiences, both personally and I think for getting a feel of what different universities are like. And those experiences will probably come in handy later in the future.
I was a first generation college student, so I had no idea about grad school applications. And I think the biggest mistake that I made was not to reach out to the departments that I really liked and ask about their programs. I think it would make a big difference.
My application process for graduate school wasn't actually very stressful because I did my graduate studies where I did my undergraduate, so it's a little bit more unusual these days. I met my advisor in my senior lab, and it was already the field I wanted to be in, so it just worked out well for me.
Not applying sooner, not doing that, starting the application sooner. I waited till the last second to do the GREs, waited till the last second to write the essays, and it was super stressful, so don't do that.
Honestly, I don't feel I made a mistake when I applied to grad school, but there is something that I will do differently, and that will be to look at programs outside of the US and not only inside the US.
Not having the guts or nerve, I don't know what you'd want to call it, to ask people for more advice than I did. And I don't just mean professors and teachers of mine, but also graduate students that I knew, just about sort of the process of getting in and what being a grad student is actually like. I'm shocked things worked out the way they did, but I would not do it that way.
Was to apply to way too many places. So I assumed wrongly that I would not get into any of the oceanography programs because my academic background was not in oceanography. Of course, that turned out not to be true. And so I got into all of the 10 places that I applied to and then was faced with this really challenging decision of which places to visit and then, you know, which one to choose. And it also costs money to apply to all those places.
Aside from putting the wrong name at the top of the first email that I sent to a prospective advisor, I'd say my biggest mistake was not knowing the diversity of funding available for students even before they get into graduate school. There's a few different grants that you can get that basically fund you as a person more so than your scientific ideas, which frequently are fairly undeveloped at that point.
I don't think I talked to enough professors. I was scared to talk to them. I think it's really intimidating sending a cold email, and I just forgot that they were real people who wanted to talk to us and wanted to find good students. And if I could go back, I would just email more people, talk to more people, and really get them to have a conversation with me and not just have an email exchange.
I only applied one place, and in hindsight, I'm glad I went where I went. I wouldn't have it any other way, but I think I would have had a lot better perspective on what grad school was all about if I had seen multiple places.
Thanks a lot for watching. Please support what we're doing. We have a lot of passionate scientists that are on board to share their knowledge and insights and their stories of how they got to where they are and how to succeed in this field and why it's so important, why science is so important. You can help us tremendously for free by sharing these videos, subscribing, and getting the word out. You can also help us not for free by chipping in a dollar or two on our Patreon account. So please support us. We'll continue to produce these videos. We do this for free. We do this because we care. So we're happy that you're watching. Thank you.